Welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School Channel. I am Priscilla Asade. Students, today we are going to learn grammar. So, till now we have finished how many lessons? Yes, we have finished lesson 6. Okay, can you recall what was lesson number 6? Yes, lesson number 6 was about nouns. Now, what we have learned in that? Okay, we have learned that nouns means name of a person, place, animal and thing. So today, students, we are going to learn more in detail about noun, that is how many kinds of nouns are there. So student, what is our today's lesson? Kinds of noun. So shall we start? And it is a request that you have to keep fun with grammar book with you, then pencil, eraser and scale along with you, so that when I will solve and I will give you instruction, that time you should not search your things. Okay, ready? So this is our recap, that is lesson number 6, that was nouns. So what is nouns, students? Yes, the names of person, place, animals and things are called nouns. Now in this I gave you some examples. So what was that? School. School is the name of a place. And what is that? Yes, she is a girl. That is the name of a person. Preeti Sen is the name of a person. Next. Now what is this? Which animal is this? Yes, dog. So dog is the name of an animal. And table is the name of a thing. So till here in the last session we have finished, that is noun. So today we are going to start with lesson number 7, that is kinds of nouns. So ready, students? Now you may be very excited. How many kinds are there? What are they? All we are going to see in detail. Okay. So how many kinds are there of nouns? Yes, there are 3 kinds of nouns. So what are they? First is common nouns. Second is proper noun. And third is collective noun. So students, how many kinds of nouns are there in our today's lesson? 3, which we are going to learn in detail. So first one is common nouns, second is proper noun and third is collective noun. So we are going to see one by one. So we will start with our first one, that is common nouns. Now what is common nouns? Common nouns are the names given to persons, place, animals and things which are of the same kind. So this is a definition of common noun, which you will find in page number 20 in a pink block. Now students, you have to look on the screen, don't look in your book. Again I will repeat, what is common nouns? Yes, read along with me. Common nouns are the names given to persons, places, animals and things which are of the same kind. Now examples, what are the examples? Yes, girl, all type of female gender we can say a girl. Then boy, pencil, country. Here we can see they have not specified any name of a girl, of a boy, of a pencil or a country. A common name is given to everyone. So these are examples of common noun. Understood, students, what is common noun? Yes, means a common name given to persons, place, animals and things which are of the same kind. Now we will move forward to the next. What is this? Yes, proper nouns. Now what is proper noun? Proper nouns are the names of a particular persons, places, animals or thing. Here what you can see, students, what is proper noun? It is a name given to a particular person, places or things. Means the name of a person, place, animal and thing, the name is specified. Clearly it is told. Now we will see some of the examples. Yes, here you can see name of a girl is mentioned, Mary. Yes or no? Specifically they have told the name of a girl, that is Mary. So Mary is a proper noun. Then next is Rohan. Yes. Third is Nataraj. Nataraj is a name of a pencil. And India is a name of a country. Now in common now what we saw, that example was girl, boy, pencil and country. And here they have specified Mary, Rohan, Nataraj and India. This was the difference between common and proper noun. Now students, one more thing you have to keep in your mind for proper noun. That is, always you have to begin with capital letter when you are writing proper noun. Can you see here? M, R, N, I. So this is a note for you that whenever you write name of a proper noun, you should always begin with a capital noun. Now I'll show you some of the examples which you can differ what is common noun and what is proper noun. Now students, what you can see over here? Yes, you can see a countries, and these countries has been specified over here. First is what? This is our country, India. Here Japan, then next is China. Now here they have specified, so these are called proper nouns, and all these countries, all these Japan, China, India, they are called countries. So this is what? Yes, this is a common name given to all the countries, and here they have specified. Understood students? Now what is common noun and proper noun? This is common noun and these are all proper noun. Next, cities. Now what are all these? Yes, these are all cities. So this is a common noun. Now when we specify the names of particular one city, that is New Delhi, Kolkata, Jaipur, so it will become a proper noun because particular name is given to each city. So these are all proper noun. So these are all what? Proper noun. And city is a name given to all these cities. Yes, and all these places. So this is a common noun. So understood students? Next. Now what is this? Godavari and river. Godavari and Yamuna, these are rivers. Yes or no? So rivers is a common name given, and particularly specified is the name Godavari and Yamuna. So what is common noun over here? Yes, rivers, common noun, and Godavari and Yamuna is a proper noun. Proper noun means a specified name given to the rivers. Now next. Yes, players. Now who are they? Yes, Sachin Tendulkar and Saina Nehwal. Okay, so these are players, we can say players, but here they have specified the name. Who is he? Yes, you can recognize, he is Sachin Tendulkar and she is Saina Nehwal. So these are proper nouns, and the common noun which is given to them is players. Understood? Pencils. If you see all type of pencils, it is given a common name, that is pencils. But if you specify a name, Apsara pencil, Nataraj pencil, any one name if you specify, that will become a proper noun. So here can you see Apsara pencil, here you can see Nataraj. So what is this? Proper noun, because properly and particular name is given to that pencil. But all type of pencil, one name is given, that is pencils. So this is a common noun. Next, days. All type of days. Now if days, if you say days, so we can't recognize which day we are mentioning. So here if we mention, or if we specify a particular day, that is Sunday or Monday, Sunday or Monday. So when we specify the name, it will become a proper name. Or Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, all these days are called days. The name is given, that is commonly given, that is called days. And specified is Sunday and Monday. Now buildings. Any type of building, if you'll see, it is called as buildings. But if you'll specify, what is this? Yes, this is Taj Mahal. This is Red Fort. So when we specifically show the picture, specifically we will write the name. So it will become a proper noun. Now, till here we have finished with our common noun and proper noun. Hope students you have understood. Now, what is the third type of noun which we have to learn? That is collective noun. Now, what is collective noun? Yes, collective noun is nothing but names of groups of people, animals and thing taken as one unit. Again, I'll repeat the definition of collective noun, which is on page number 21. Collective nouns are names of groups of people, animals and things taken as one unit. Okay, so you can see our students, groups, the word groups I have made it bold. Why? Because a group of people, group of animals and a group of things which are taken as one unit, that it is called as collective noun. Now when I will show you some example, you can understand what is collective noun. Now what you can see here? Yes, so many cows are there. Yes or no? So this group of cows, they are given some name. What is that? A herd of cows. So whatever examples I will share you here in this PPT or image, you have to carefully look, because you have to solve this match the column afterwards, which is on page number 21. So a group of cows is called, which name is given to them? Yes, see, I have underlined over here. A herd of cows. Now what is this? So many fishes are there. Yes or no? So these fishes are given one name. A group of fish is given one name. That is called a school of fish. What is the name given? A school of fish. Now next. Yes, can you recognize these men? Yes, they are all soldiers. So they are in a group. So they are called as, yes, army of soldier, an army of soldier. So these are collective nouns. So name given to group of people as a one unit. So that is a army of soldier. Now what you can see over here, students? Yes, it is biscuits. Yes or no? So biscuits, what name will give? It is in one box. So it's a box of biscuits. Understood, students, here? Okay, a herd of cows we have finished, school of fish we have finished, army of soldiers we have finished, a box of biscuits. Next, what is this? Yes, these are all wools. So group of wools are also given one name. What is that? A pack of wools. Can you see here? Yes. So what is the collective name given to these wools or a noun? Yes, a pack. A pack of wools. What are these? Yes, bees are there. Yes or no? So these group of bees are also given one name, and that is called a swarm of bees. What is that? A swarm of bees. Again, I'll repeat. We will say a swarm of bees. We are not going to say a group of bees. Yes. What is this? Yes, a group of flowers, a bunch of flowers. So one name is given to this bunch of flowers. What is that? A bouquet of flowers. How you are going to pronounce this word? A bouquet of flowers. Next. What is this? Yes, what are these? These are sheep. So these sheep are called a flock of sheep. There is a difference between sheep and sheep. Okay. So these are sheep. So what is the collective name given to this? Yes, flock, flock. Now in the next example we can see about ships. Yes, ships, this ships, these are ships. So this group of ships, they are called as fleet of ships. Okay, so the collective name or collective noun for the ships is fleet of ship. So the eighth one was flock of sheep and ninth one is a fleet of ships. So you have to just see the difference between sheeps and ships. So till you understood, students, what you have learned? Okay, now we are going to solve the exercise. Are you ready, students? Okay, open your fun with grammar book, page number 20. Ready? Take pencil in your hand. So this is lesson number 7. Okay, ready? This is exercise A which we are going to solve. So in exercise A, are you ready, students, with your pencil, eraser and everything? See here what I am going to do. Here numbers are given, yes or no? One, first one is boy. Okay, so here in one column some common nouns are given and in the other column name of a proper noun is given. Means what you have to do? You have to match the common noun with the proper noun. See, for time being, what I am going to do? In front of one, that is boy, what will be the answer? Yes, answer will be Rahul. So I am going to write over here only E. In your book, afterwards when you will finish, you have to just match it with scale. So ready, students? Yes. So first one is boy. So boy answer, see, just see in proper noun, what is the answer? Yes, Rahul. So you also write here E. Now second is girl. Any girl name is given? Yes, that is Richa. So write over here C. Third, city. Any name of a city given over in proper name column? Yes, what is that? Mumbai. So answer is G. Now next, see students, you have to solve along with me. Only write whatever I am giving, afterwards you match it. So next is country. So which country name is given in the proper name, proper noun column? China. H. Next, river. Which river is given in proper noun column? Yes, that is Godavari, that is F1. So I am going to write here F. Next, school. Any school name is given? Sixth one we are solving. Yes, St. Joseph Convent School, that is in B. Seventh, continent. Yes, so which continent we are staying? We are in Asia. So where is Asia? D1. So we are going to write over here D. Cartoon character. Any name of cartoon character is given in that? Yes, that is Donald and Duck, that is A1. So students, have you written like this? First one is boy, Rahul E. Girl, Richa C. City, Mumbai G. Country, H1, that is China. River, F. Godavari. School, B, that is St. Joseph Convent School. Continent, that is D, Asia. And cartoon character, that is A, Donald and Duck. Now we are going to solve next. Take out page number 21. Ready? Okay. Students, what we are going to do here? Page number 21, exercise B. See here, what is the instruction given over here? Rewrite the following sentences using capital letters wherever needed. See here, they have told rewrite the following sentence. As there is no space over here, what I am going to do? I will only underline the word which you are going to do a capital letter. Now first example, what is the first? Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Now where do you think that there should be a capital letter, means proper noun? So M will be capital. Maharashtra is the name of a city, so M will be capital. Yes, these are proper noun. So proper noun always start with a capital letter, even though it is in the middle of the sentence. And in sentence lesson we have learned that always a sentence begins with a capital letter, means all these first letter will already come in capital letter. Now next, Rahul Sharma came first in the race. Now what do you think? Rahul Sharma is the name of a person, so R will be capital, S will also be capital. Just now only you do underline. Next, I have read Ramayana many times. Yes, I always comes in capital letter, so I will underline I. Now again, which word will come as a capital? Yes, Ramayana, as it is a name of a book, so only I am going to underline R, that is Ramayana. Fourth, my parents are from Kolkata. As this sentence starts from M, so M will be capital. Okay, and Kolkata is the name of a city, so we are going to underline Kolkata. Next, H, then Shimla, name of a place. Smita, Namita, name of a person, so capital. Modern High School, name of a school, so we are going to make it capital. The first word of a sentence, so T will capital. Taj Mahal, name of a place, a name of a building, and Agra is the name of a place. Hope students, you have done till here. Okay, next we are going to solve exercise C. Ready? Just see what is the instruction given in exercise C. Ready? It is very easy. Only you have to be with me and you have to do along with me whatever I am doing. Now read the instructions what is given in the exercise C. What they have told? Underline the common nouns and circle the proper nouns in the given sentence. Okay, again I will repeat, wherever you will find common nouns, there you have to underline it, and where you will find proper noun, there you have to circle. Ready everyone? Okay, so students, you should be able to recognize what is common noun and what is proper noun, which just now I have taught you. Ready? Okay, so my birthday is in December, so here common noun is birthday, and the month is specified, so proper noun is December, so I am going to circle the proper noun. Understood students? Okay, yes. Next, my father reads the Times of India in the morning. Okay, so what is the common noun over here? Father. So for common noun we are going to underline. Then what is proper noun? Yes, name of a newspaper is mentioned over here, Times of India, so you have to circle it. Students, do it with me so that it will be easy for you. Next, Vishesh and Vishal play cricket in the park. Now here we can see these are proper noun, name of a person, and cricket, name of a game, and park is common noun. Now Leopard has black spots on its body. So leopard is proper noun. Spots and body is common noun. I will visit Europe in January. As the name of a country is specified, this is a proper noun. And name of month is also specified, this is also a proper noun. There is no common noun in the fifth example. 6. The school remains closed on Saturdays. School means commonly it is talking about all the school. So this is a common noun. And what is the day mentioned over here? Specified Saturdays. So that is a proper noun. Now the play is written by Shakespeare. So the play is common noun and Shakespeare author name is given. So Shakespeare is a proper noun. She stays in Ranchi. So Ranchi is a proper noun given over here. Now we will move on to the next. So now students, we are going to solve even, which we are going to solve. D1 already I have told you, I have explained you in collective noun. Then too, if you want, you can do it. A herd of cows. Okay, a herd of cows. A school of fish. An army of, yes, you have to try, soldiers. Next, a box of biscuits. A pack of oats. A swarm of bees. A bouquet of flowers. And last but not the least, a flock of sheep. Again I will repeat, last is a herd, again I will repeat, a herd of cows, school of fish, an army of soldier, a box of biscuits, a pack of wolves, a swarm of bees, a bouquet of flowers and a flock of sheep. Now we will move on to the next exercise, that is D. E. Okay. Exercise E, what you have to do students? Page number 22. Okay, what is there in that? Find common nouns, proper nouns and collective nouns. You can see one grid is given in your book. Okay, and some letters are bold. Yes or no? Okay, so what you have to do? You have to read the sentence and in bracket they have given you, you have to find common noun or proper noun. That you have to select it from your book. Can you see over here? Okay, so first is the statements. Is a dash. It is a common noun. So newspaper, so it is there in the second, we can say row. So like this you have to finish till 8. So students, what we have learned in our today's lesson? Yes, we have finished with kinds of noun. So in that, how many kinds we have finished? Yes, we have finished 3 kinds of noun, that is common noun, proper noun and collective noun. So what is common noun? Common noun is nothing but a common name given to a person, place, animal or thing. And in proper noun, the names are specified. and collective noun is nothing but a name given to a group of people, places, animal or thing as a one unit. Hope so students, you have understood all the three kinds of noun. Only today's homework is that page number 22, you have to do it on your own, and whatever exercise we have solved, match the column, that you just draw, match it with a pencil. Thank you. Have a good day.